Brothers Karamazov, recorded live in performance by LA Theatre Works for your listening pleasure. The passionate Karamazovs spring from the pages of Dostoevsky's Titanic novel. The aging roué Fyodor Karamazov entertains himself by drinking, womanizing, and pitting his three sons against each other. The men have plenty to fight over, including the alluring Grushenka. When a murder is committed, the three young men begin a moving journey towards mutual understanding. And now, The Brothers Karamazov, dramatized by David Fishelson from the novel by Fyodor Dostoevsky, featuring John DeLancie as Ivan, Sharon Gless as Grushenka, Ari Gross as Alyosha, Harry Hamlin as Dmitri, and John Randolph as Zosima.
Let me just sit here for a moment and catch my breath. Are they here yet?
They're inside, I think. Maybe we should postpone this, Father Zosima. You don't seem
to be... No, I'm all right.
I just don't trust that my father and brother are sincere in coming to you for this arbitration of theirs.
This fighting of theirs over money frightens you, doesn't it?
I can't be sure the two of them genuinely want peace.
All men want peace, Alyosha. Though I admit your family may be a special case. Your three grown-up sons who haven't set eyes on each other since you were children, abandoned by your father when your mother's died, raised by different relatives, and now you all come together again to meet like strangers in your father's house.
And yet, even though I've only known my brothers a month now, Father, I'm already dreading the day they decide to leave our town again.
Must be you've come to love them already.
Then I hope they'll come to love me, too, before much longer.
You'll always be loved, Alyosha. It's a gift you have that you don't even understand yet.
But they avoid me, Father, both Ivan and Dmitri. They can't accept the fact that a Karamazov wants to become a monk.
Well, perhaps they know something you don't yet, that your place is not here, and never was.
What are you saying, Father, that I should leave?
Let's go
that...
and see if we can help them, shall we?
Do you think it'll be much longer?
Father Zosima should be here any minute, sir, if you wouldn't mind being patient for just a little
patient,
while longer.
Patient?
Yes, sir.
You monks are the only ones who can afford to be patient. All you do is eat cabbage soup all day and try to make sure no women get into this godforsaken place. I just hope this monastery is on the up and up, since you want my son Alyosha to spend the rest of his life here eating soup. Listen, I've heard that even at the monastery on Mount Athos, they not only forbid women, but any creature of the female sex. No hens, no cows, no female sheep. Now, what's the point of that rule, I wonder? Particularly the sheep.
You promised to control yourself, Father.
Huh? What?
You
right,
promised.
Oh, yeah. Yes, right, I did. Yeah, okay, all right. For you, Ivan, I'll do anything. Alyosha, punctual to the hour. And you, Father Zosima, I am honored to be in your presence, or so they all say I should be.
Father, please.
But as you can see, Your Holiness, my eldest son Dmitri isn't here yet, the one who brings this shameless claim against me, and which you have so graciously agreed to arbitrate. But I am always punctual myself, as you can see.
It's all right. I'm sure your son will be here soon.
Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Alyosha's brother, Ivan.
Your brother speaks of you often, Mr. Karamazov. And your articles in the press have stirred up some excitement here as well.
Yes.
Well, I'm sure you exaggerate, sir.
Listen to him, listen to him. Such brilliance and modesty in so young a man. Why, all the society women are crazy about this man. Oh, your reverence, imagine this humble father's pride in two of his sons, at least.
If I might, sir, my name is Father Joseph. Your latest article has puzzled some of us here.
Which article is that, Father?
The one where you write that the only reason men love their fellow men is because they naively believe that if they don't, they might be punished in an afterlife.
I remember writing that, yes?
Yes, but you also wrote that because of this fear that self-interest should now become the principle that religion is based on, not love.
Are these really your opinions, young man?
It's what I wrote in the article, Father Zosima.
But what do you believe, my son, apart from what you've written?
As to
whether God exists... and our souls are immortal.
I only know that if there is no God, or heaven if you will, Then our only conclusion can be that everything is permitted.
Everything?
Yes.
Even crime?
Yes, perhaps.
But you're not certain.
No, not certain, though I'd like to mention in my defense, perhaps, that I summed up the argument by saying that I thought there was just enough religion in the world to make people hate each other, but not quite enough to make them love one another.
You see, Your Holiness, how my mind might be poisoned by such blasphemy, and yet I might love this one most of all. Mwah! But ever since he came to live in my house, Your Reverence, questions have started nagging at my mind, and you may be the only man alive who can answer them. I heard a story somewhere about a holy martyr who was tortured for his faith, and when they finally cut off this man's head, he apparently stood up, picked the head off the ground, and kissing it affectionately, I believe that was a phrase, walked a long way, carrying it in his arms, kissing it affectionately. Now, is this a true story or not, Reverend Father?
No, it's not true. I've never heard such a story.
I had a feeling maybe it wasn't true. Your Reverence, forgive me. I just invented that little story for the hell of it. You see, I like making a fool out of myself so that people will like me better. The problem is my jokes never work, and consequently people can't stand me. Tell me, Your Holiness, do I insult you with my high spirits or not?
You, sir, should rest assured that there's nothing to worry about. Above all, don't be so ashamed of yourself, for that's the root of it all.
My God, the man is right! Blessed man, let me kiss your hand. You know, every time I go out in public, they take me for a clown. So I say to myself, all right, let me play the clown. I don't care what these bastards think. You see, Father, it's my sensitive nature that makes me misbehave. But I make up for it all by believing in God, sir. It's only lately I've had my doubts. You see, my son Ivan here, since residing under my roof, takes pleasure in bothering me with certain questions.
I never bother you with questions.
But questions burn in my mind all the same, Your Reverence. Now, you want my son Alyosha to join you here, so you better take the time to answer these doubts. Why, I have heard, though I can't confirm the rumor, that you practice flagellation what? In this godforsaken place.
Father, what are you saying?
And I shall write to the Father Superior about it tonight, and then I'll be forced to take Alyosha out of here at once, this very day.
Forgive me, but it was said of old, if they should speak against me, I must console myself by saying it's the medicine of our Lord, and he has sent it to heal our vain souls.
Oh, get out of it. That's just so much more rubbish. Tell me, fathers, why do you fast anyway? I mean, do you really think there's a reward in heaven for it? I say, be useful to society first, then shut yourself up in a monastery at somebody else's expense. The toiling Russian peasant brings his kopecks and he lays them at your feet for salvation. For shame, fathers, for shame, you suck the blood of the people.
It is written again, suffer gladly the dishonor that befalleth thee, and be not confounded, and hate not him who... Oh.
Forgive me, Father Zosima. But I was deliberately misinformed by my father's servant as to the time of this meeting. Twice I asked him when it was to be, and twice he told me 12:15. Now suddenly I realized
don't
that...
Don't worry, my son, it doesn't matter.
This is my eldest son, Dmitri, Your Holiness. The shame of my old age, who claims I owe him 30,000 but won't dare take me to court.
Please, don't insult the members of your family.
He won't show me his books! As if he had something to hide, for God's sake.
I have an exact account of every kopeck he's ever spent, and if he wants to see it, let him sue me. Not one ruble of his inheritance remains.
I have never understood the system this man uses in giving me advances on my estate. Now, I have always maintained that if he...
Who could believe a word this hypocrite ever says? Everyone knows I almost threw him out of the army for gambling and fighting duels, and that his debaucheries with women are the gossip of St. Petersburg, and even our little town here, since he showed up a month ago to bother me. Why, I even heard he spent 5,000 in one night trying to seduce some young girl.
You're a liar and a hypocrite yourself.
Gentlemen, we
deny
need
it.
To resolve this.
Deny it.
Please.
Deny that you haven't publicly humiliated your new fiancée, the daughter of your colonel, to go running after some woman, some common slut on the eve of your wedding.
No, you distort everything. You turn everything into lies.
And this poor fiancée of his is rich, gentlemen, rich. She's a millionaire. Christ, man. If it's money you want to pay off your debts, why don't you just marry the rich little fool instead of hounding me with your lies and threats?
Before these holy men and my brothers! How dare you besmirch the name of Katerina in my presence? It's an insult to her, and I will not permit it!
Don't you forget I am still your father! What have I sent you packing with a father's curse, you miserable liar?
It is I who curse you!
Ah! He curses his father! He sins out loud! You all heard him!
All the evil in us comes from you! You infected our souls and poisoned our lives! I vowed not to say a word against him today, but now that he's spitting out these lies, I feel duty-bound to tell the truth before all
Ivan,
of you!
Ivan, stop them! Do something!
What for? Dmitri Fyodorovich! If you...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.